Good morning and welcome to this week's Lakefield and Young's Point United Church online music service. As we continue to gather remotely with our church family and with the wider church, we thank you for joining us. We may not be able to gather together physically at this time, but our hearts are one for God and Christ and the Holy Spirit. Come in and sit down. Dear Lord, we thank you today for all of your blessings, and we remember that you're always there in the midst of all the chaos in our world. Prod us, remind us to look to you to carry our burdens. We pray for your hand on our world today. We pray that we, as your people, allow you to work through us to bless others and to show your love to all those we meet. We pray for our leaders and government officials that they and we will be good listeners, as your word says that we are to be quick to listen, slow to speak, and slow to anger, so that we can produce righteousness. Help us to be righteous and to live as Christ did as he walked this earth. Thank you for our church family near and far, and help us to work together to do your work, and to act justly, to love mercy, and to walk humbly with you. In Jesus' name, amen. Let's sing together Like a Healing Stream. Let's sing together Like a Healing Stream. Thank you. That I've seen over the last week or so. COVID-19, riots, protests, cancellation of concerts, the changing of racially offensive product names, damaging storms, new math curriculum, stage 2 opening, mandatory mask wearing, deaths, house fire. Here's my favorite from the last week. Quote, Canadian Tire Lindsay temporarily closed after every item scanned comes up as Mr. Potato Head. I'm going to choose to focus on that one because it makes me feel better. Most of the headlines, though, make me feel angry or sad or frustrated or even opinionated. Well, maybe other than the Canadian Tire closure due to Mr. Potato Head scanning issue, that one definitely had me chuckling. How many headlines have you read lately that make you feel uplifted or positive, happy or fulfilled? If you were to write a headline about your life this week, would it mirror the feelings of those that you've read in the media over the last little while? If you were to write a headline about how you reacted or dealt with the relationships in your life, how would it be written? I know that my daily headline doesn't always read the way that I'd be proud to have it printed. How are we to be as Christians and followers of Christ? How should our headline read? Ephesians 4, verse 29 says, "Do not let any unwholesome talk come out of your mouths, but only what is helpful for building others up according to their needs, that it may benefit those who listen." That was interesting. What is helpful for building others up according to their needs, that it may benefit those who listen. Ephesians 4, verse 32 says, "Be kind and compassionate to one another, forgiving each other, just as Christ forgave you." Forgiveness is hard. Micah chapter 6, verse 8 says, "He has shown you, O mortal, what is good. And what does the Lord require of you? To act justly and to love mercy and to walk humbly with your God." It's hard to be humble. It's pretty hard to write feel-good headlines these days, too. Reporters around the world certainly have a lot of negative things to focus on and to write about. But what about us in our daily lives? If we were all to act justly, love mercy, and walk humbly with God, could we help to rewrite some of the headlines in our news? I think we could. What better place to start than to rewrite our own life headlines every day? I lost a dear aunt this week. I thought of what some of her headlines might read. Some I came up with were, "Laughed so hard that the tears flowed," or "Kicked cancer to the curb," or "Proof that miracles do happen," or "Faith and love abound in my heart today." My own headline regarding her passing might highlight and focus on loss and sorrow and heartache and injustice. Or perhaps my headline could read, "Rejoicing in the love of our Savior and Lord, who is embracing our beloved and faithful Penny Obi in heaven today." How do we choose to write our daily headlines? What are we doing each day to write an inspiring headline? Here's a little project or challenge for you. Spend some time writing a daily headline for yourself. Before you go to bed at night, reflect on your day and reflect on the interactions throughout the day. Reflect on your challenges or blessings and jot down your headline for the day. How difficult is it for you to write a positive and inspiring headline? Perhaps if we focus on writing our stories each day so that we can write an inspiring and exciting headline, we may be on the road to something good. Share some of your headlines in the comments below, if you would be willing. Those headlines might help us all to focus and refocus, focusing on good stories and be inspired by the simple and yet wonderful things in our world. Blessings to each and every one of you, and I pray that your life will lead to inspiring and uplifting headlines. Amen. Thank you.
Our next piece is a Twyla Paris tune called We Will Glorify. Sing with us this song of praise to our Lord of heaven and earth. Give praise to the one who gives us life and who helps us to write our headlines every day. Hallelujah to the King of Kings, the Lamb of God, the Lord of Lords, and the great I Am. We will glorify.